Hello, today I'd like to demonstrate how to properly climb a utility pole and the proper equipment that's needed to do so, right there. Okay, first thing you're going to want to do is you're going to need a climbing belt with a climbing strap like this, and put it on. Now, when you put on a climbing belt, the way that you want to wear it is just above your hip bones, below your waist. Because when you climb the pole, you're going to be sitting back on your belt. And it can't be around your waist, because that's not good support. And it can't be too low, because then it'll fall down. So it has to find a nice sweet spot right there on your hips. And you want it as tight as you can get it. Okay, the next piece of equipment that you're going to need is a hard hat. Then, climbers. Now, these climbers have hooks on them, and if you look closely, there's a small little curve right here, because when this climber goes into the pole, it goes in, and then it has like a little platform that it presses down on, and those have to be shaped just like that, not like spikes, but that shape in particular. Put them on. And lastly, you need to have thick leather gloves that are made for climbing. And they're thick because whenever you climb a pole, over time the wood starts to get dry, and pieces of wood will come off in big, huge splinters. Now, if one was to fall off of a pole and that one of those splinters broke loose, it could possibly impale you under your chin, in your upper body, in your legs. These gauntlets, what we call them, go around your wrists, and they help to prevent that. So if someone was to lose their grip or lose their connection to the pole, what we're trained to do is, unfortunately, push off the pole and fall. Because if somebody tried to hold onto that pole and slide down, it could kill them. The splinters could get, they're so large, they could literally go through your entire body. And so you don't want to do that. Okay, next thing you want to do is you want to put your strap around the pole. Make sure that the way that they connect to your D-ring, these are D-rings here, is with the hook out on both sides, just like that. Now, to adjust the belt so that it's the proper length while you're climbing, you put your arms in here and you measure the distance like this. The length of your forearm between the pole and your upper body is a good estimate. Now, this is the hitchhike method of climbing. There is another method called free climbing, where you wouldn't use a strap like this. You'd simply hug the pole or put your hands on the pole and climb hand over hand. But this is the safer method. This is the method that I prefer. It's a little slower, but it's safer. So once you get your strap on the pole, take your one foot, lift up, drive it into the pole, hike up a little bit with the belt, step up, put your other hook in, and lift up, and just start stepping up and hiking the belt up. You see an obstacle, or if you catch an obstacle, grab the pole with one hand, lean forward with your upper body, leaving your legs at a 45 degree angle. Inspect to see what it is, lift up over it, then lean back. Get yourself balanced again, take a step, hitchhike back up. To come down, you simply do the reverse, and when you step down, you let the weight of your body drive into the pole. And alternate feet coming down. Step off the pole. Take off your belt. And that's it. Now, before you go anywhere or go back to your vehicle, continue working, you want to remove your hooks. Because of the spikes on them, you could accidentally step and impale your own leg, or you could damage something, or you could damage your hooks. So you need to remove them. In fact, the safety rule is to don't have them on except within a 3-foot radius of the pole. Alright, that's it. That's the basics on how to properly climb and dismount a utility pole and the proper safety equipment that you need. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you.